your right.
The what?
The nose.
Oh, yes, I do.
Right, I see the nose too.
trails. What do you mean, like there?
Walking trails, hiking trails.
Along the top.
Okay. Yeah, I guess there's not a lot of walking trails on this side. There's at least one, though.
There's a cliff house trail, but
we're not near that.
And they're going to be a lot harder to find.
Yeah, understood.
To the Lake of the Clouds to my right.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, nice.
You see the lake?
Yeah, I guess that's that little thing?
That's the Lake of the Clouds.
Wow. I see the walking trails. Is that the thing right there?
Yeah, you can see all the people on it.
Oh, yeah, I guess I can.
They're all pointing at us going, wow, look at that.
Yeah, wow.
That's fine.
Okay. Oh, that lake.
I think this lake here is the Lake of the Clouds, right here on it.
What's that one?
Stowe Soaring.
Stowe Soaring.
Oh, okay, right. Cool.
And there's Spruce Peak down there.
So, Stowe Soaring is a lot bigger than Lake of the Clouds.
Yeah, Lake of the Clouds is not that big.
Right.
The Art Center. It's down by 1 o'clock. It's down there
okay.
now.
Okay. All right.
But that's where we've had those great holiday meals.
Yeah.
By far the best holiday buffet around here.
Yeah.
I can. We touched down in the Burlington Airport in a hot air balloon a couple weeks ago and flooded.
So there's Shelburne Point. There's the Heroes.
No, Shelburne Point is over there. That's Marble Island.
Oh, you're right. Okay, that's Mellon's Bay.
And there's Juniper Island. You see it?
I do.
The big bald spot between us and Juniper Island is the airport.
Oh, okay. Got it.
You see the aircraft carrier out there?
Yeah, Juniper Island. I spend way too much time looking at maps.
Plus, he spends a lot of time over this particular view.
I fly a lot for work.
But we haven't been right over Mount Mansfield before.
Yeah, Dewey Mountain.
Oh, now there—that's Sunset Ridge, I think.
No, I don't think so. Sunset Ridge would be to my right. Well, I can't see what you're seeing.
Right, I know you can't.
But then south of here is Dewey West Mountain and Clark Mountain and Mayo,
Sunset Ridge go right near the nose?
It goes, yeah, pretty much right up.
Well, that's it then, I'm positive.
Well, no. The Frost Trail goes up to the nose of
Wapahoofas. Oh, then it's the Frost Trail.
The Wapahoofas Trail.
Then it's the Frost Trail right below us. Or the Wapahoofas, whichever.
The Wapahoofas Trail is that fun trail at the very end, right before you go up the forehead.
Okay, so I was just...
But Sunset Ridge is going to be over to your left.
So, right below us now is what I'm talking about. Yeah. Maybe you can see it now.
The two trails that come up from Underhill are the Lower Cowles Trail, which is a really steep one, and the Sunset Ridge, and they both go to the nose. I mean the chin.
Oh,
that's a building down there that I've never seen before. One of those trails going by. Maybe it's a shelter.
Yeah, maybe it's a...
Taft or, let's see, Butler Lodge.
That's the cliff house there, isn't it?
Yeah.
The only reason I saw it that time was because the sun was reflecting off it. I never noticed it before.
Take the gondola up to the cliff house and then walk the cliff house forever to the chin.
I don't think we've done that. Or maybe we walked all the way up it.
There's view of the notch. There's another little house, but I have seen that.
Oh.
Right off the wing.
Oh yeah, I do. There's a little shelter right there. Or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. It looks a lot like a Green Mountain Pop shelter.
It could be. It could be a...
On some other brand.
There's a golf course down there I never saw before. But then you don't see it if you're not up here.
Yeah. Or unless you're a golfer.
Radius, the turn radius of the airplane is wide.
Why would you think about anything else?
Yeah, that's true. It's kind of like if you're beautiful, why bother being smart? Well, I did always want to fly.
What?
I have always wanted to fly with my body, I mean.
Directly in my finger at the ridge. The white, there's white stuff on top of the ridge.
Which ridge?
The left farthest ridge.
Farthest. Oh, I do see. Okay. You mean the ones we saw at GMP?
Yeah, I assume those are the same ones up in Sheldon.
Yeah, okay.
Some more over here at Sheffield.
We went up there and it was so quiet, it was weird. We thought they'd make more noise and there was just whoosh. But nothing noisy.
Everybody's complaining about
the
noise. Yeah.
Yeah, we went up there and it's like, what noise?
They're silent. They really are. At least as far as we're concerned. Maybe when you hear it constantly, it might gradually build up on you.
Well.
Kind of like when you eat salty food.
Yeah. Or when you snuggle otters.
Yeah.
Snuggling otters.
Oh yeah, I know. Please do.
Yeah,
what are we looking at now? Morrisville or?
Yeah.
Nice bog. Good otter bog.
It's going to roll like on the horizon. Not the horizon. Where's that big white roof is?
Can't see it. It's got a wing.
Okay.
Oh, there. Okay. Uh-huh. And that's the Worcester Range over there, I guess. White rocks and Mount Hunger and... Montpelier's over that way.
Okay.
Remember, we went up to White Rocks one time. There's a real nice little light.
I think so. I can't really remember where from.
From, you know, you get off in Middlesex and you go up and there's all these dirt roads.
Okay.
Tube and just go snorkeling. Because I've seen otters eat strawberries and raspberries.
Yeah, raspberries.
Snorkels.
Yeah.
there's another glider taking off.
Here's the airplane that we were just talking about.
Yep.
Pointy peak.
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
dials on the one on the top.
Oh, okay, I see now.
Yeah. Here on the farthest right.
Brick is broken.
Oh, that explains it.
What'd you say?
It's broken.
Oh.
And the lower one, acceleration, it says?
That's broken. So that's how many That's how many G's you're
pulling. Oh, okay.
You don't need those.
Yeah.
But the one on the left that I can barely make out, that's how fast I'm rising or falling.
Yeah, but it's different than an aircraft vertical velocity because instead of being calibrated in hundreds of feet per minute, it's calibrated in knots up and knots down.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That way, if you're going and if your airspeed's in knots, which it's supposed to be, you can calculate your glide distance.
Right. That makes sense.
Yeah, now we're going up. If this works out, if you did the math, it's almost hundreds of feet per minute also.
We're rising a lot right now.
Yeah, we are.
That's a pretty strong thermal.
Yeah.
So we've gained about 500 feet.
Great, neat.
God.
Okie doke.
Do you ever have people throw up here?
Every once in a while, not too often.
I wouldn't, you'd have to be really sensitive, because we're not really...
Well, like the bank we just did.
That was fun.
Yeah, that for when we were banking to the left for a moment, I was like, wow. I mean, I'm not airsick easily, but it was the kind of moment that I was thinking if a person was, that would do it.
Yeah, but that was over quickly too.
Yeah.
That was fun.
And that was a lot higher level of terror.
Such a beautiful day though.
It was. And it is.
You guys jump on an airplane.
Only
just
once.
And you look and sound so intelligent.
It's fun.
Really?
It's fun. It was a little terrifying for a minute, but it was totally worth doing.
We were doing it down over Addison on a beautiful fall day. Just perfect.
I would be happy to do it again.
I've done it twice, but neither of them were on purpose.
No.
And I had a round parachute.
This place looks familiar.
Yeah.
That's good. GoPro, stop filming.